When your husband leaves for a deployment, you know that there's a very real possibility that he is not coming home to you, and that's just something that each wife has to deal with and figure out how she's going to cope with. But you know that it's a possibility, and nothing can really prepare you for that. But none of us really consider the fact that our husbands might come home and we might not make it. So when we first found the tumor, I was terrified, to say the least. I didn't expect it. Nothing prepared me for it. I thought I was just having really bad headaches until I had a headache one day that the right side of my head went completely numb down into my neck and shoulders, and it lasted for several days. So I had to go to the doctor, and through a series of MRIs, we found the tumor. And then in the second MRI, when they went to get a better look at the tumor, they found seizure activity. And so they decided to take another MRI to see if they could get a little bit better look at the seizure activity. And what they found was what was the most terrifying. They found what they suspected was a complicated tumor wrapped around the entire top portion of my brain. When the neurologist told me about that, I can honestly say I had never been so scared in my life. We've been through, this was my husband's fourth combat deployment, and I thought that I had pretty much been through it all. There wasn't anything that I couldn't handle during the deployment until the doctor said the word tumor for the second time. And so I took my three kids down to the lab. I had to have a lot of blood work and different things like that that needed to be done. And while we were waiting in the lab at the Naval Hospital, I took the kids into the bathroom and I cried and cried and cried because I was terrified. Who's going to take care of my kids? What am I supposed to do? Who's going to help my husband with this? What's going to happen? It was terrifying, all these unknowns. And then what happened was right before I went in to get the different blood drawn and different things like that, the neurologist called me and asked me to come back up to her office. And as it turned out, what they saw on the top portion of my brain was not actually a complicated tumor. It was what's called temporal lobe sclerosis. It's severe scarring on the right portion of my brain and a little bit over onto the left side. So that made things a little bit better. I still had a tumor and I still had seizure activity, but just the fact that here was one thing that was not as bad as I thought it was really just a relief in and of itself, especially because I knew the other tumor was something that was workable. It wasn't going to kill me, and they did not suspect that it was cancerous. So that was the first of the personal battles that I had to deal with dealing with illness.